thank you for joining us today, and welcome to the second CBRD public lecture entitled Quick but Clean Survey Research, co-sponsored by the Center for Business Research and Development and the Office of the Vice Dean for Research and Graduate Studies. I am Mar Adriel Umali, lecturer from the Financial Management Department and Research and Administrative Assistant for CBRD, your Master of Ceremonies today. To begin this event, let us all rise for the opening prayer to be led by Mr. Patrick Aure, Research and Administrative Assistant of CBRD, to be followed by our national anthem.
Let us all remember that we are in God's loving presence. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, we adore and thank you for this day, for gathering us and allowing us to learn new things which we may apply in our studies, research, and practice. We are blessed and honored to have an esteemed guest in the person of Dr. Ned Roberto, who will share some nuggets of his wisdom, tempered by his national and international experiences as both an educator and practitioner. May you grant us the blessings of the Holy Spirit as we endeavor to learn quick but clean survey research from one of the most respected marketing gurus in the Philippines. Let this be a venue for imbibing the values of St. Basal as we pray our silent prayer. I will continue, O my God, to do all my actions for the love of you. St. John Baptist de la Sal, with Jesus in our hearts, pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please remain standing for the Philippine National Anthem.
College of Business for her welcome remarks.
Good afternoon, guests and students.
Mike.
Okay. So I understand we have about 70 outside guests from different universities. And of course, we have our students, many of whom are in the research class. I welcome you to this event, the Center for Business Research and Development has come out with a series of seminars, and we always welcome you to attend all of these. So it helps all of us build a culture of research, which is something that we need in education, as we try to move forward and to compete globally. Because as you are aware, soon enough, by 2015, we have a free flow of students, faculty. So it's going to be truly an international and globalized education. Now, today is very special. I welcome you here to listen to a Professor Roberto. Professor Roberto was my professor twice. When I was taking my master's at the Asian Institute of Management, as well as my doctorate here at De La Salle. He was, and I was conversing with him, he has mellowed over the years. No? When I was in AIM, my husband actually was one of his first victims in class. So we have a case in AIM, it's all cases. You just learn with multiples of cases a day. And in one of our classes, Professor Roberto started to write at the far end of the blackboard. He just kept, you know, my husband was talking, and then he started to write. And then, so after a while, so we all stopped, we all kept quiet, the students. And then we just said, what are you doing? Right? And he said, no, your answers are too far out. It's out of this world, right? So, that's kind of the answers. Hindi wala sa board, that's a dulo ng board, okay? One of the first, and you will always get stories like that. So, he would teach a class, and we had a case of Benihana, and where you have to, you know, it's a cooking. You know Benihana, no? Japanese food. And all of a sudden, he'd stand on the table, right? And start to pretend to throw knives. And catch it because that's the performance in a Benihana restaurant. So anyway, so and for me to take him twice, no. So I know many of the things, and if innately I have been making a lot of marketing related decisions, it is because of that constant prodding and how he trained us to think marketing. So this is a very good opportunity to be here. You imagine that opportunity to listen to one of the guru of marketing research in the country. You know? So he's the only one with a PhD in marketing research here. So, and then of course he's at this point in his life where he would like to give back, and that's why he's back here to De La Salle from where he took his education, right? And then, of course, he went abroad for his further education. But this is this time now. So I'm hoping you learn a lot. You listen. It's quite a quick session, right? Of course, we have, you know, he's been mentoring some of our faculty on a more, on a weekly basis for the last almost a year already. And then he has some other projects with us. So it might be a good way to appreciate and understand marketing, which is something we will all really need later on. Okay, so I welcome you because I think I'm overstepping into the introduction of the speaker. Now, so I'm only supposed to welcome you into this event. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Santiago. At this point, we would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge our guests from the following universities. From the University of the East, Manila, welcome. From University of San Carlos, Emilio Aguinaldo College. From Arellano University, Pasay, welcome. From DLS College of St. Benil. From DLS UDAS Mariñas. And from Cultural Center of the Philippines. From Central Colleges of the Philippines. I apologize. Thank you. So before we proceed to the main part of our event, I would like to call on Dr. Raymond B. Habaradas, the Director of the Center for Business Research and Development, to formally introduce our esteemed guest.
This for the benefit of the younger ones and the learned, who might not be aware of your various achievements. It is my honor to introduce my mentor, Dr. Ned Roberto. He is one of Asia's leading authorities on marketing. He is a much sought-after consultant, speaker, author, and educator. He has taught at De La Salle University in Manila, Northwestern University in Chicago, and INSEAD in France, and at the Asian Institute of Management. In 1983, he received the Philippine Marketing Association's Agora Award for Marketing Education. Dr. Roberto has consulted and conducted in-house seminars for Fortune 500 companies in the US, Europe, and Asia. He is the author with Philip Kotler of Social Marketing, as well as User-Friendly Marketing Research, Strategic Market Segmentation, Socioeconomic Classification of Consumers, Segmenting, How to Change the World, a Manual for Social Marketers, and Quick but Clean Social Marketing Research, a companion book to How to Change the World. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Ned Roberto.
Good afternoon, everyone. Magandang hapon po. I came in early to check the props. And I found that if I speak from here, I actually will be blocking the sight of these people here, although there's a screen over there. So you might want to look at there instead of me, because I'm not a very good sight to look at. And so with the other portion of the audience. I would like to speak the way I'm used to, which is basically I myself manipulating my PowerPoint slides. So if you will, pwede ba? Do that po? Okay, thank you. Very quickly, initially, of course, I would like to start by thanking our dean, Dean Jeannie. I never got used to calling her by her first name, Jeannie, because it reminds me of a television show a long time ago, okay, when many of you were not yet born. But I guess, what's wrong with calling her Jeannie? Isn't it? It's magical. And she has done a lot of magic already. Over, wala pang 1 year, ano din siya po, di ba? 5 months pa lamang, oh. See? So it could take another 4 months for her to give birth to the innovations that she wants to implement. And there are many, okay? I want to thank, of course, my favorite mentee from his favorite mentor, because he is only one. I'm kidding aside, I want to thank Raymond. Because this was his idea, huh? I came here as a mentor. From the other person I really want to thank, because he was the one who started it all. See, Brother Ricky Laguna, who could not be here, because this is not that important to him. Sorry. Right, so Raymond thought about this, and when he first talked to me about it, I thought, oh, wow, well. Then I was persuaded, because he says he is thinking of inviting other representatives from other schools with whom I can share what I was sharing with them as mentees. Anim lang kasi yung mentees ko. Okay? And over the certain period of time, nag-go 1 year na kami, ha? So we started last November. So the end of October is the end of the first year of this mentoring exercise. Okay? So, sabi ko, oh, baka okay yun, huh? to share, so that the things that I am sharing, which culminated in something that Dean Jeannie had thought about, which is to set up a DLSU COB, that is a business survey research center. Ano siyang center? Mas maganda yung vision niya, oh. See? To be a survey research agency of choice that will ultimately equal the largest survey research center in the world. Sino yun? Ay, naantok pa kayo. Oh, sige. Wake up, children. No, the largest survey research center in the world is not AC Nielsen. It is the University of Michigan Survey Research Center. As the largest, as the biggest. Pero, not for profit siya. At time, we will also be not for profit. Right? So we will have an advantage over the AC Nielsen, the DNS, the BSRC, the Sinovate, and so on. Because we are in research for the love of research. So matang sila, they are for research for money. Di ba kasi from suklam yan? Hindi naman, okay? We also need money. Okay. So this is about, see, my latest book and the subject matter of my mentoring, okay? Which is how to do quick but clean quick but clean. Hindi yung quick but and dirty. Okay, that should be, see, after this session, that vocabulary should be outside your language.
Okay.
Quick but clean. To say scientific, okay, with attention to external and internal validity, and cost effective, move. Okay. Survey research. Okay. Survey research over the years has become a second language of business. Second to what? Klasiko ito, marami nang dalawang pack dito. Ang sumasagot. Second to one. What's the first language of business? Okay, yung pala eh. Okay. Pero mo, see, it's a janty pa sa bubot. Yung mga faculty nga dito, sumasagot. Ha? Ay, di ba sa janty, ha?
Teacher,
yeah. Teacher, okay. Alright, okay. Thank you very much. Okay. Oh. First language of business is accounting, okay? But over the years, see, more and more, see, your survey research has become the second language of business, both in actual practice of businesses as well as other institutions, especially non-profit, see, NGOs, as I will show you, okay? So, what shall we cover in the 15 minutes? Or let me just quickly tell you, patuhan. First, I want to share with you how to do, how, kasi ang concept ng mga eskwelahan that I have given a training on survey research. When I say, ano ba yung, how long is a quick but clean survey research? Sabi lang, at least 1 year. Yung lagi na dito eh. Sabi ko, bakit 1 year? Kasi ganun daw sila. Okay? When they had that PhD, it took them at least 1 year, and usually an average of more than 1 year, to complete their dissertation, you say. Oh, see, so, kung ganun katagal yun, okay, and you are trying to solve a problem with the survey data that you are going to collect and analyze, patay na ang problema, patay na ang kabayo. Okay? So, I want to share with you my experience in getting quick but clean, cost-effective research, survey research, in at most 3 months, 13 weeks. Okay? And some of my experience in setting up a do-it-yourself research group in companies, see, we have what I call instant research. Sa Globe, I was able to set it up. Sa Smart, also setting it up. Okay? Diba kalaban yun? Eh, professor ako eh. So they don't suspect me of anything like sanky-punky. See, if I am consultant to both, okay? Kasi kala nila, matino ako. So, in any case, pwede po, 3 weeks was. And we completed. It's quick and clean. Clean talaga siya. See, it's internally and externally valid, which I'm going to show with this. So, una, my experience in quick but clean survey research in my social marketing research projects. Okay. So, my training was really, my dissertation was in the area of social marketing. Okay. So later on, you will see what social marketing is all about in its application. After that, okay, I want to share with you, see, my quick but clean survey research in applied marketing research project. Ito yung sa mga businesses. Okay. And then I draw the lessons from all of these, from these two. See, and how to organize, how do you set up your framework? It's square hand. Okay, because my concern is with schools. Okay? I started here in Lasal. See, I was the first and only training assistant and research assistant of Bernie Villegas when he set up here in Lasal. See, kasi ako yung favorite student niya when I was early akong student here. Okay? So we set up a Department of Economics, see, kasi economics muna ako kagad noon, see, and then we had our first survey research project with Bernie and Father Piron and myself. Of course, all the legwork was being done by me. I don't regret it because there's nothing like learning by experience. And by the whip of Bernie Villegas and the kicking by Father Pilon, the late Father Pilon. Okay? And finally, see, the last one is, I said, okay, so how do we transform all of the things that we are talking about into research professors in our school? Okay, come here. Or learning from my social marketing research project. So I have a lot of PowerPoint slides because I thought, initially speaking, sabi ni Raymond sa akin, this is going to be a two-hour session. 1 hour and a half is for my blah blah. Then, last night, as I was preparing for this, nakita ko, binasa ko ulit yung invitation. Sabi ko sa invitation, you have 50 minutes. You can't have 90 minutes. Panic. Okay, so what did I do? I reduced my more than 200 PowerPoint slides as much as I can, down to sana 100, di ba? Kasi, 1.5 minute per slide, yeah, at least I would have 100 slides, di ba? I was successful only to reducing it to 120 slides. So, I will exceed by 26 slides, therefore, by 2, 13 minutes my allocated. Do you mind, Ray?
I don't mind.
Oh. I hope you don't mind those. Wala naman kayong choice. Okay, so, what about this? So, I will abbreviate, see, and sometimes I will skip some slides, see, to get to the point where I'm going to conclude. I think yung interest ko dito sa project na to, okay, my interest is always, somebody is challenging me. Dinuduro ako. Okay? I like that. Okay, bakit? Kasi I'm a writer, I'm an author. Okay? So, my first bestseller book was User-Friendly Marketing Research. Okay? Nagkaroon ka rin ng second edition yun eh. Bakit? Kasi sabi ko dun sa estudyante ko sa IIM where it was first used. I will give you the highest grade if you ask me a question which I cannot answer. Putang dami. So, I had no materials for a new edition. Okay? So, I came up with a second edition. So, in the next set of classes that I had built in, okay? So, I had materials for a third edition. Okay? Then I retired from AIM. See, so now I'm here. Sa Lasal. And then I'm also teaching in Ateneo. Okay? Yung nga sabi ni Brother Laguda, you traitor. How dare you give to an institution who has not given you anything? Why don't you give something back to the institute that you owe to most? So, brother, sino yan? I kid around. See, that's why I get into trouble. I kid too. All right, so here's another one. Like HRD, Human Resource Development, if you have a project in HRD, you start with needs assessment. Okay? You always start where your customers, or in the case of social marketing, where your intended beneficiaries are. Never start from where you are as a social marketer or business as a marketer. Okay? That's just to be the case. Huh? During the times in the 80s and even first half of 90s, see, we say, ano yung marketing? Oh, 4 P's. Ano yung 4 P's? Kasi ako yung naggawa ng, hindi ko kasalanan to ha. Ako yung naggawa ng survey research ni ERAP. Okay? And when ERAP was elected, of course, I invited him to give a talk at the AIM. And he said, I know you. So I was the one who invited you. Oh, what are you doing? What's marketing? Marketing research, actually. Olympia! Di ba yung 10 P's? Sir, 4 P's lang. You don't know the latest. So, sabi ko sana, sir, it's time already for your talk. So, pwede tayo magloko, ha? The protocol officer was behind me, sinifay mo. And he says, "What do you know? That's why we mentioned Jubilee BP is there." So, no, accommodate him.
it's a small short joke. I said, ano yung naman? Ano yung 10 P's? Ito.
P, 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 P.
So, my instinct was it, oh, I'm calling you. But I was stopped. Oh, kaling naman, sir. Oh, kaling nyo. I'm kaling nyo, sir. Can I include that in my set of jokes? Why do you have my permission? So anyway, see, no. When you say, what's marketing? We say four P's. That's wrong. Half wrong. Okay, why? Because it's not four P's. Because let's start you from where the marketer is. Okay? Always start where your consumers, your market, and in this case, say our constituents and beneficiaries are. Okay? So, ano sila sa needs? Okay, so, ito yung needs assessment na ginawa ko at the specific level of problem. So, meron akong mga needs assessment sa social marketing at the level, see of a entire community, see, and then at the level of a family level. Huh? So, ito naman, see, ito, see, this is a nationwide study that I conducted and finished and presented in October 2006, a national survey of giving behavior of Filipinos. Okay? Oh, bakit ako naka-interest doon? Kasi I was challenged by yung mga mayayaman. Like who? Like the donor of this building. Sabi ko kasi, sir, do you know that, see, my survey shows that it is the rich who gives the least to the poor. So yung sabi niya? Yung sabi ko siya. Okay? I told that to NBC, it's all the building, and so you change this building, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And of course, Lucio Tan, he was my client at the time. Okay? And the Sorianos and then the Ayalas, okay? So we are not true. Okay? So we go. Are you ready to back up your challenge? So we go, yes. Or can you give me a budget? Oh yeah, so lend me another budget. So I did the survey. Okay? So they designated the 15 beneficiary causes. See, that I was going to cover in this ano. So 15 giver segments, and then as advocated by three types of organization, NGOs, church-based, and government organizations. Okay? So, and the questions that we answered were the following: how big is each of the different giver segments? Okay? So in terms of market size, see, geographical segments, as well as socioeconomic giver segments. Which is the concern of those who are challenging, right? Yung mga mayaman, sabi ko, oh, we give a lot. We give much, much more. Sabi ko, if you reduce this as a percent of your wealth, talaga mo wala. Okay? Which is the one that came out, huh? So awareness of social causes and their championing, tapos yung, see, what is each giver segment's priority importance for the 15 social causes, okay? Where I prove that, see, there are, kasi sinasabi rin sa kanila, yung mga social causes, lahat yan high involvement sa amin. We are concerned with each of those. So, almost dito. No, they are not concerned. See? For some of those causes that I have, that came out, okay? So, yun yun. Tapos, then, how should giving behavior be measured, okay? So, yeah. There was a debate about that. Eh, percent pala yung kinukompute mo eh. See, siyempre, maliit yun. Excuse. So, siyempre, as a researcher, this next one is what giver segment attitude must be changed to change a giver behavior? Because we all believe that attitude, it must be changed first in order to change behavior, di ba? That's almost taken for granted. Yeah? I showed you that is not true. If you want to change behavior first. And then the change in behavior will change attitude. Okay? Partition the behavior, like for example, register for a campaign,
Oh, yun, yun. Umpisa na yun, ba? So then lock them into that, see? And then go on to the next partition of the behavior. And you will attain your... Yeah. Once they change their behavior, sila na lang mismo magsasabi, ah, ganun pa rin naman, okay pa lang naman. Well, sometimes they change their attitude. And it's quick. Right? So anyway, there are those things that I was able to establish here. Okay? You know, it's giving behavior a function of giver attitude. And ito ang lumabas eh. No. Attitude has a very minor influence on the giver behavior. Okay? Okay? Yeah. If you measure it by R square, right? Oh, 7% explanation of variance. Passive influential, right? So, so when I was presenting, in the first half of my presentation, siyempre yung mga mayayaman, sabi na, pointing to denial, na, but as I presented and continued to talk, right? Okay. So there's something wrong with us, right? What should we do? Kasi yung mga action man, mga tao yan, di ba? Mga mayaman. So ito, during the presentation itself, oh, they made the suggestions. See? Oh, then, why not, see? Ito, mga, siyempre professor ito, mga professors to. Okay? If attitude is not the biggest influence on behavior, then it must be in some of the other variables, extraneous variables. Like what? O, sila ka nagsagaling na ito, ha? Ito, sa Ateneo yata ito, ang grupo of Ateneo professors, right? Siyempre, ba? Kanya na ito, Institute of Philippine Culture, sila Ricky Abad, right? I think it's the perceived social normative pressure to give that is the more important determinant of behavior. Another? Oy, I'm just kidding, ha? Baka may parating sa Ateneo. Hindi na ako pagpasukin ito. Okay? And then, oh, the other things. I'm giving as a modeling behavior. So, the Skinnerian theory of behavior. Ha? Giving out of a giver's perceived self-image. Good for my self-image. Ha? Social psychology. Okay. Then, the perceived capability skill for the giving behavior. Which is underlying our, just say no to the drug addiction campaign. And then perceived lack or felt barriers in the giving behavior, okay, which is a sociological theory. Tapos, yung iba, so what? Jason Cole, he was the biggest donor of this survey. Okay? Batang-bata, huh? Unfortunately, he came from Ateneo. Sabi niya, you know, Ateneo accent, you know, most often, giving is hampered by a simple thing like non-availability of work to give, outlets for time, the place where to give, instructions, procedures, steps how to give. If you think about it, many times you talk naman, di ba? Pag nasa, we're in the church, okay? So, pag wala yung collection bag, okay, sabi mo, where will I give? Diba? Tapos sabi, doon no? Eh, public yun, diba? Tapos bumunod ka, 20 pesos lang lalagay mo. Yan hiya ka. No, not available. Wala pwede yun. So, I said, oh, see, why don't we do that? See, I will include all of those variables in my next survey and it will be a richer survey. Okay? So, ito pa, oh. Learn from the church, sabi nung isa. Okay. Tignan mo ang branding ng church about giving. They did not say donate. Instead, they said love offering. Kadig talaga. Lasan yan eh. Diba? So, mahusay sa branding. Okay. Come. College of Business. Come. 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 Okay. So I'm famous for that kind of corny lasagnes. It's a more compassionate brand name. Love offering instead of giving. Diba? Giving kasi patin. But more redeeming brand name. And then subtle use of peer pressure. Diba? Bakit? Ayan, oh. Lalagpas na sa'yo yung bag, diba? Okay? Tapos, bumunod ka. Tapos, 20 pesos na, oh. Diba? Tapos, I think it's planted eh. See, the church makes sure that you are with, beside somebody who will look at you. That's peer pressure. Then, don't come, ay, sorry. 20 pesos na, oh. Just pesos. No, the same kind of peer pressure, okay? So, no, I do not, sorry, oh, I don't know that. See, as a liquid statement to which you agree or disagree. Okay? Then learn from the CRM. What CRM? Customer relationship, the marketing or management. Giving is a function of, is a reminder phenomenon. So just like consumer shopping frequency is. Actually, I want to give more, and to give more often, but I just keep forgetting. So kung may mag-remind sa'yo, sumubay ka naman, hindi ka. Ay, sorry. Ayaw ka. Ay, hindi. Eh, kaibigan, bigay ka naman, diba? So you might be, all of this can be put together for a second survey, ha? Huh? Okay, see, ito naman mga born-again Christians. Eh, my son is a born-again Christian. And I must say, he was transformed a lot. To my admiration. Kasi nga, dati-dati. He's my favorite son because he's my only son. But then, when you became born again Christian, completely transformed into a sense of what? He became an assistant interpreter. And then most of all, he established a relationship with Jesus Christ. Okay? So, hindi siya kapareho ko, nagmumura. And he corrected me. Okay? He says, Dad, you should never, never, never curse. So, when I curse, I don't mean it. Something even then, if you curse, that is mocking Jesus Christ and praying to the devil. So, but I thought about it in the evening, and in the next morning, see, I had an annunciation moment, and I just said to Saint Gabriel, "Be it done unto me according to my son's words." Okay, so now we are closer together, see, thank God, and we live happily ever after. Not in the sense of my husband's lover. Son and daddy. Okay, so obvious, diba? Kung ano? Okay, so, paano yan? See, it is a quantitative survey research. And let me describe to you, see, a sample size of 1,200, which in my class on statistics, I say, is large enough for you to talk about, see, a margin of error of plus or minus 2. Okay? And then, equally partition among the different geographical regions, right? 300, 300, 300. And therefore, at that point, we are now not violating the requirements for external validity. Huh? So how quick was this? So from design to data analysis, ladies and gentlemen, 30 minutes. Okay? So how clean? Okay. When I say how clean, we're talking about two requirements of validity. One is called internal validity, which among psychologists is the most important validity. Kasi nga, yung mga psychologists, starting even with Freud, who wrote one of the most influential books that I can think of. Are you measuring what you intended to measure? That's internal validity. Huh? Okay, so anyway. So, ito yung dalawang requirements noon, see? See, first interviewed, see, the target 1,200, okay? And all of them, walang substitution, huh? And then pre-tested the revised and revised per the survey questionnaire, patterned after the awareness, knowledge, the attitude and practice survey and framework in the first the survey research wave of the venture for capital. Mayan Cabrera. Alright. Tapos, and then, yung second validity requirement is external validity. Is what you measure generalizable and projectable to the total population that you are studying. Okay? And then the requirements are, per study area, sampled at random, not very much random, but statistically, random. Okay? And the second, she implemented a statistical random selection, of qualified respondents within a randomly sampled household, using a probability selection key. So all according to statistical requirements. Okay? So we practice that. This is now the Survey Research Center of Dean Ginny here, the head of which is my other favorite mentee, Luisa. Right? She will be the superstar of survey research of LaSalle when we are over this training, right? And over, we are now into actual survey research implementation. Huh? Lumayo survey research project na dinadali nito si Luisa, right? Can you imagine that? Loading yourself with 3 survey research. Okay? She must be out of her mind. Little one, right? I like it. Because she's busy. Okay? That's the way to get away from temptation. Then I have my favorite topic, of course, is in advocacy, is in poverty research. And this one is a qualitative research, okay? And the challenge here came from Don Songko. See, I don't know if you wrote. Don Songko was the chief of staff of the Cory Aquino administration. Right? And he came to me after the term of Cory, and he said to me, Doctor, can we ask for your assistance? Yeah. So, see, favorite ko si Cory. And do you know that my wife's name is Cory? President Cory ought to meet my wife. Okay. But it was Sarah. She was pro Marcos in the shop. This is the past, you know? So Cory now is her favorite president. Okay. So anyway. So sabi ko, among the poor. Kasi the poor, by estimate of SWS, is 80% of the total population. Huh? But the 80% partitions into 3 sub-segments. There is a 40% borderline poor. Hindi po yun. Borderline. They come in and out of poverty. Okay? According to what? According to the weather. So tama si Eric dyan eh. Pa-weather-weather lang yan. Diba? No. Kidding aside, because of mga ganyan, disaster, okay? They go back to the poverty. Tapos pag may maganda ng mga panahon, they go to the middle class. Kaya yung nagsasabi na the middle class is disappearing in the Philippines, it's not right. See, they are not looking at the sub-segments of 80% of the poor. Okay? Tapos, may 25% who are the middle poor. And there is a 15% extreme poor. Yun ho ang tunay na poor. So sabi ko, sino dito don't ang tinatarget ng bagong NGO ni Presidente Cory? Sabi yung borderline. I'm sorry, I cannot join you. So, bakit no? Because if the borderline poor escapes poverty, you do that, it's because of you. Diba? They come in and out because of the weather. Right? So, if you want to have an impact, let's help the extreme poor. So, I'm sorry, the policy and the objective has been set. So, sorry, din ha. Pag handa na kayo, pumunta doon sa extreme poor, I will help you. I don't blame them. Bakit? Kasi new NGO, di ba? Kailangan mong pakita na mayroon pa ng kagad effect. Where will you get an effect immediately? A borderline poor. Di ba? Kasi in between 1 year, mayroon pa na mapakita ng gano'n, di ba? So anyway, so I will skip this. Okay? Ano yung gusto kong pakita dito? Kasi sabi niyo doon, kaya wala kami sa extreme poor. Wala nung entrepreneurs dyan. This is an NGO for micro-enterprise and micro-finance. Walang entrepreneurs doon sa That's a research question. Don't. No, we know. Rose, how do you know? No, they have observed that. Okay, so let me not challenge you there. See, I will just say raise funds so I can do. Eh, maliit lang naman tong research na to, qualitative research na lang, ha? Just to show that there are indeed many entrepreneurs, micro-entrepreneurs, see, in the extreme poor. So, pumunta lang ako sa UP, ang kasundo ko sa doing this kind of research, si Dai Ferranil, who's a social worker, right? Sociologist, okay? So, we went to Payatas at saka Santa Mesa Riles, okay? So, yun, yeah, Payatas food store, may picture pa tayo, food store. Tapos to our surprise, mas maraming food store kaysa sa sari-sari store. Okay. But they're all treated, tapos, okay. But they're all, kagaya no? So this is in-depth interview, okay, an observation, okay. So itong isang panito, 47 years old, okay, of course, huh? And then, as you can see, sourcing of raw material, okay niya, lahat ng paninda ko, sa Talipapa, sa urban ko, binibili, okay? Oh, tapos naman, sourcing of raw material. But ako, oh, magbabasa ko.
Madaling araw ako, namamalayke. Mga 4 ng umaga, nilalakad ko lang papunta at pabalik. Tapos pagdating sa bahay, handa agad ng lulutuin. Para sa pang-almusal, may champorado, dugaw at sobas. Sunod yung spaghetti para i-display na ng 6:30. Mas maraming dumalating pag umaga. Mga kapitbahay dito na nabili ng almusal. Bihira lang ang dayo. Tapos, pahinga. Pag nakapahinga na, luto naman para sa tanghalian. 2 hanggang 3, putahe lang. Kasi matumbal ngayon at walang pasok sa eskwela.
Okay, what does that say to you? Okay? See, these micro-entrepreneurs know what their business is. Okay? Kasi ganito. Later on, si Mark Ruiz, together with Tom Aquino, currently Senate President, to be President 20 years from now, asked me for help also, huh? Because they set up Hap Pinoy. Okay? So, anong question ba nila eh? Ano kailangan ando dun sa stores namin? Sabi ko, ano yung stores mo? Sari-sari store or food store? Mag-upis na kami sa sari-sari store. Okay. Pero, eventually, we also include the food store. Ano yung kailangan mong bantos? Sabi, Diyos ko naman, di ba? Para ka naman high school graduate, kung magtanong. Ano nga lang kira, di ba? Why don't you go and observe? Di ba? Kaya makikita, kausapin mo. Okay? So, makikita mo lahat, ha? Kasagot ko. Anyway, so, meron na pong, yun, Now this is, I would say, this is today's latest craze is so-called inclusive growth. What's inclusive growth? It is about programs that is meant to eliminate, see, to make poverty history. Okay? So I would say, itong short study ito has implications for those inclusive growth program. Ha? Bakit? Kasi, I say, oh, stop calling the borderline poor, see, as the enterprising poor, as if there are no entrepreneurs found in the extreme poor market segment. There are. Okay? So, oh, change poverty segmentation priorities. Kasi, the most need and the segment where the biggest difference is to be made are with the extreme poor. Okay? So, reach out to this segment first. Okay? Well, see, so micro enterprise implication. If you're wondering, see, guy ng Hap Pinoy, sila Mark Ruiz, si TJ, at saka si Bam Aquino. First of all, tingin nga to Bam Aquino at that time. So, bakit Bam ang pangalan mo? Kaya naman yan, pag naging presidente ka, di ba? Punta ka sa state, so, okay, the president of the Philippines, Bam! So sabi, hindi, kasi nung buntis daw yung nanay niya, kasi yung tatay niya used to drunk ng chan o the nanay, di ba? Ang sabi daw nung tatay, bum, 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 bum. So anyhow, see, if you're wondering whether to put up a sari-sari store or a food store, stop wondering. Put up both. Okay, why? Because, that's the first entrepreneurial venture of the extreme poor. Right? Now, if you're searching for what products to carry in your store, search no further. The right bell. See, you know? See, all you have to do is to observe. Okay? So, ano klase itong research na ito? Ito nga, see, it's a qualitative survey research. See, how many respondents were observed and in-depth interviewed? Ayun nga, food stalls, sa Payatas, tatlo, Santa Mesa, tatlo, Sari-Sari Store, tatlo, na Payatas, see? Sa Santa Mesa, tatlo rin. So, see? Ang gabing dalawa na, okay? So, how quick was this? Just go. Okay? 3 days, 3 days, and 4 days. Okay? Is that clean? That clean? So, in the US government I have, which is quick but clean research, I said, it will be clean. Okay, if you have selected your respondents according to the norm by which a clean qualitative research will be done. What's that? Think the criteria of respondent selection should be not random because this is not quantitative. Therefore, it should be from whom will you learn the most. That's the criteria. Huh? So therefore, okay, you have to screen and pre-qualify that way. Huh? All right. So ito naman, see, this is a, ito yung, ang nangyari naman dito, ganito, okay? So, I'm part of SWS, okay? So, when SWS was presenting their, our research on poverty and hunger, okay? So, see, Dick Romulo, who was at that time president of Makati Business Club, stood up and then said, okay, ang dami-dami nyo lang research sa poverty. Hindi man lang nababawasan ang mga poor. So, and then Dick was looking at me. Okay. Why? Okay. He says, well, you are in business. Okay? Mahal is doing research in the public sector. Okay? And most of this research has been actually, public sector directed, if you include NGO as part of the public, okay? So, but you are in the business sector. Can you not do something about, the poverty alleviation programs? Sabi ko, suddenly po, sabi ko, ganun naman itong city program, di ba? Look at his name. Doon lang ako magigimbal ka na, Dick. So I formed my hypothesis. The hypothesis was this: the poor remain poor and still remain poor, okay, because of the supply side, not the demand side. Then the supply side, managers of poverty alleviation program, are they doing right? Are they managing the program, the way that management science should be telling them to do? Oh, yeah, so it's even research go. So, and there's a group of people who rose to the occasion. Okay? Who are those group of people? Kasi wala mag-support ito ng survey na to. Okay? So I went to here. Okay? So, and luckily at that time, the late Phil Alfonso was the vice president for faculty development. So, persuaded him, okay? Pwede naman konting pera. This is what I'm going to do, huh? It's a different research. It's not a research on the poor themselves. See, but those who are managing the programs to alleviate poverty. Okay? Okay yun, huh? Ano mukha? Talagang okay yan. And it will make a name for you, Phil Alfonso. Okay? Saan? No, because you're trying to make a name in the corporate social responsibility, di ba? Kolektado dito. Okay ka. Hindi mo lang pala nalaman mo. Okay. Okay. So, yan. Right? So, this is a quantitative research project. See? So, limited size because we were after a go-no-go decision. Is this, are this poverty alleviation program manager doing okay or not? Okay or not is a go-no-go kind of decision. So therefore, all you need would be a sample size that is still tolerable, na? Meaning what? Yung talagang valid pa is 100, na? Sample size 100. If you go down to 50, okay pa rin yun, ha? But below 50, you should have an asterisk on all of your data, which says that, okay? Look at all the percentages with caution. Kasi malaki na ang margin of error. Pag pumunta ka sa 30 and below, ang asterisk mo doon, according to statistical norm, is that, see, you should not even compute percentages because the margin of error will not allow you to do. Okay? E 50 ako. Okay? So I still, how quick? Or sampling frame development was long. Okay? Bakit? Kasi hindi kami makakuha ng ng listahan ng program alleviation, okay, alleviation programs and the managers there. Okay? Kasi, man daw, highly confidential. Sabi ko, ano na highly confidential doon? See, bakit? Meron na bang napolis doon? No? O if napolis had happened at that time, see, I would say that. Di ba? Bakit? Oh, this is, lalo na sa government agencies, di ba? Anyway. Okay. So, then, see, questionnaire formulation and pre-testing, 36 days. Then data analysis plan was 14 days. Okay? Medyo mahaba siya, but still, okay, relatively shorter than what all of us in schools are used to. Okay? And of course, internal validity, okay, I follow the same daily requirements and criteria, so I claim that we have both internal and external validity. Huh? Okay? So, where to start the program? Ito yung findings ko, tingnan mo. So in the interview, if kayo as poverty elimination program manager, how do you start your plan, your program? Okay. Sabi na, needs assessment din. Oh, ganun. So do you do a survey for your needs? Oh, ito yung answer ng Daughters of St. Paul, huh? And the religious group. Okay. So no. The needs of the poor are known. Sabi ko, saan? Mother's spirit and mother. Okay? She's a, imagine, I call her mother, then my call her husband, but I call her mother. Mother likes, diba? Okay, so, anyway, so, it's known, it's in the Bible, the needs of the poor. So, ano mo lang sabi sa Bible? The poor are poor because they do not lead a God-like life. That's the one. See, different PPP or poverty alleviation programs work according to different models of poverty costs and consequences. Each poverty alleviation program's starting point is defined by that model. Yung sinabi ko, yan o. Poor are poor because they are deficient in moral values. So having that reading of their need, saan kayo nag-umpisa? Paano yung programa nyo? How do you define your program? Ano nga, katikisin. Bibigisin ng katikisin. Of course, you do not laugh. See? Don't laugh. Because if you laugh, you alienate them. You can never be able to help them. Huh? So, di ako nagtawa. So, I accompanied. See? Sabi ko, Mother, saan mo yung anyo? Poverty Elimination Program ninyo? Oh, marami kami. See? And yung susunod na bibisitahin nyo, pwede ba ako sumama? Ah, sige. So, it was in Balayan. Among the poorest of the poor. Who are what? Our fishing folks. Okay? So we went there, what we discovered was terrific. Huh? See, those mothers, were feeling miserable, not because they were poor, but because their children, were practically thrown out of their classroom. And they sent them there. Okay? So I go, bato kayo alam? Kasi pinagalitan yung mga anak namin at pinagalitan din kami nung pinatawag kami. So, ano ba nangyari? Yun nga, sabi na napakatatanga daw ng aming napakatatanga at napakabobo ng aming mga anak. Can you imagine that? Pauline Bo Sanchez Bobo? I was telling Bo Sanchez. I was with Bo Sanchez this weekend, see, sa Cebu, because I was one of the speakers. Anyway, so, eh, totoo ba na, kasi sabi namin, napaka-responsable nyo naman mga magulang, hindi tutulungan yung mga bata para mag-aral, para makasagot sila pag tinatawag namin sa eskwela. So ano nangyari? Eh, hindi naman hubobo yung aming mga anak. Pero, wala lang humakain. So gutom kung pumasok. So kaya hindi makasagot. Okay? Sabi ko, yun pala, ba't din yung sinabi yun? Eh, nung, eh, ang umpisa nga sa amin eh, napaka-responsable niyo yung mga magulang eh. So, it's like, bakit pa kami sasagot doon? Okay? Hindi malaman kaya nung sabi ko. Oh, anyway, so, the mother superior was listening. Sabi niya kagad, see, Dr. Len, thank you very much. Okay? Now we know where we should have started. We should have started this way. See, finding out what is the real need. And the real need is food for hunger. Feeding program. Pero, after the feeding program, dapat doon sila pupunta parang sa katikisin, di ba? So, maganda learning yun, di ba? See? So, what they did was now to transform their feeding program into two. Okay? So, one is for hunger, the other is for nutrition. And then, pasok lang mo doon yung sa ano, ha? Tapos sabi nga nung Radyo Sofiyo sa akin, Dr. Len, do you know about Shakespeare? Doon eh, lasal ako eh. So, hindi namin pinagkakalala si Shakespeare eh. Anak ko, tinatay na yan eh. Parang sa ano. No, see, kidding aside, Dr. Len, eh? Because Shakespeare has a character in one of his plays named Cato. So, ano yun yan? Because Cato said the following, it's hard to talk to the poor because their stomach had no ears. Kanta naman, mother. Mother, kanta. I love you, mother. I love you. I love you. Isabi mo niya, I love you too. Wala nangyari, ha? So, the need assessment is founded on this kind of model and is based on the Bible. So, program application, develop a program for a spiritual formation among the poor. Yun ang pag-upisan nila. This is okay. Yung catechism is okay. If the immediate and longer term needs of the poor, it converts in that need, di ba? Pero hindi eh. Magkahiwalay sila eh, di ba? So dapat mag-upisa ka dun sa immediate, ha? Okay, so how often is this the case where our poverty alleviation program starts with their model, see, of poverty? Very often. See? So, ayun. So, Nisha said at the community level. Okay. So, meron akong ganun, Nisha assessment at the community level. This is my work with Governor Josie de la Cruz, see, of Bulacan, then with Cagayan de Oro, si Mayor, then with Palawan. Sorry, it's not my fault. Si Reyes. And many others. Right? So, and the challenge to me was very simple. Okay? How does a government official at the local level keep pace, okay, and keep monitoring the changing priorities, okay, of his or her constituency? So, yun ang motivation dun, ha? So, this is a social marketing research project that was very exciting to me because it's ended up as a book. Okay? So, oh, yun. Hindi ko na kapalit na. Yan. Yung mga stages yan. So, look. The summary of... Kasi ganito nagawa niya, oh. Okay? Just the summary. For the most significant insight-rich resource, see, the final research has to be scientifically conducted quantitative survey research. Okay? Tapos na, so the research must follow the requirements for a valid, generalizable qualitative survey, representative, random, see, and no substitution for internal validity. And then, so the challenge, see, and here's the challenging validity currently used. Kasi sabi sa akin ng even Josie de la Cruz, sabi niya, meron naman kaming feedback from citizens. Eh. Ano yun? Public hearing. So, public hearing is vested interest. Hindi ba? So, it's not random. It's not representative, right? Tapos sabi niya, meron din kami backyard survey. backyard walk, basura ang kukuha niyo doon. Feedback from local leader. You know, see, your local leaders wants to protect you. Diba? So, napaka-bias mo na, ha? Alright, so for inciting qualitative research, kasi here, I combine quantitative and qualitative. So much so that I was able to say, okay, kasi laging tanong sa akin ng mga kliyente natin, is, ano ba to? Qualitative or quantitative? Hindi or, and. Okay? So, your quantitative usually will tell you what's going on, see, among your constituency, okay? When you present it, then there will always be somebody who will ask you, why is that going on that way? Okay? And your answer cannot be from the quantitative. It has to be the qualitative. So that's when I draw my respondent from, see, those respondents in the quantitative who answer that way. Hindi yung ginagawa natin na, see, when we have an FGD or an in-depth interview, we draw our respondent any which way. Para daw random representative. That's quantitative research. See, and the norm is not going to be the random representative. That's for the quantitative. Okay? It should be from those who, from whom you will learn the most. Who are those? Those who answer that way in the quantitative. Huh? So I do quantitative first, then qualitative. Okay? Before, everybody does first the FGD. Okay, bakit? To learn about the area, to learn about the respondents here. Sabi ko, ganun. See? Who are you? Where are you born? See? A long, long, long time ago. Kasi, yung search engine natin, you can learn everything about any subject matter, about any market segment. Okay? In fact, if you go to Facebook or blog, okay, you will find out what they're thinking. See, so hindi na kailangan yung quantitative survey mo to be preceded by qualitative research. Okay? That's antiquity. Okay? I'm sad to say. Okay? Anyhow. So, let me skip that. Okay? So, tapos meron din ako research for social advertising or what is called IEC. Okay? See? Which is information, education, and communication. Let me just cite this one, because this had an impact. It has an impact especially for me. Kasi nga, see, I call it the ethics in choosing the IEC media. Okay? So this is a 2004 study with my friend Quasi Romualdez. After his term as a secretary of health, okay? And he became president of Friendly Care Clinic, and he asked for my help. And then, tulong ako dito. Sabi ko, kala ko ba, you're my friend. Anyway. Sabi ko, kaya ka lagi nagdududa, kasi yung pangalan mo, Quasi. Ibig sabihin, semi Romualdez. Semi lang, hindi totoo. Kalahati, totoo, at hindi. So, you didn't like the joke. So, I suppose you didn't also like the joke, because nobody was laughing. Okay? So ang finding ko doon was that the media that is really the dominant media that was used to get acquainted about and to have information and have education about Friendly Care Clinic was personal media. See, we learned this about Friendly Care Media from friends, neighbors, see, family members, relatives, and from the authorities. See, the nurses, the midwives, the doctors in Friendly Care. Okay? So, TV came as the most nominal source. Okay? And as you will see, okay. So, this study conclusion was therefore, yung IEC of the Friendly Care client shouldn't be personal media. That's the primary media. Therefore, yung investment nila of 20 million was. Clinic lang to, 20 million, see, on TV. It's misdirected. This is a misallocation, di ba? Okay? So, kasi sabi ko, so, but why did they have to choose TV? And why did they call this an ethical issue? I'm sorry. Oh, so, medyo inalis ko yung PowerPoint. Okay. Because the donor agency was USAID. And the expert that the USAID hired was an American. Okay? Was just finished with his MBA. Okay? Was assigned here. Okay? And, see, for knowing any better, see, it says that you ought to invest your $20 billion in TV. Because that's what people watch for information. Sabi ko, pumayag. Sabi ni kasi naman, hindi ako pumayag. Yung board ang pumayag. Wala pa ako. Talagang di-disapprove ko yun. Okay? No, you can disapprove. You are the recipient. They are trying to help you. Okay? But they're helping via a person who does not know yet. Okay? Nakausap ko nga yung consultant na yun eh. See, when I was presenting this, I'm like, my God, I made a mistake. No. See, they will admit that they are wrong. Okay? If you just tell them. See, sometimes you need to educate your own donors. Okay? And USAID is no exception. Okay? But the 20 million has been spent. Diba? Always allocated. Okay? Fine. So ito nga yung aking hero, si Thomas Henry Huxwell. What do you say? My belief is that no human being or society will come to much unless their conduct is governed and guided by the love of some ethical idea. Okay. 20 million, no? Done. Eh, may mga dyan, 10 billion eh. Ano ba mo nireklamo natin eh? Tapos ito naman sa pricing. So, kasi this one issue when I was helping Governor Josie and some other mga governors and mayors. Why is it that I'm helping those? Kasi gusto ko tulungan yung sa ilalim at saka sa ibabaw. Yung president sa ilalim, okay? Doon sa itaas, hirap kang tumulog doon. Not because they refuse, but because the cordon sanitaire is too thick. Okay? So I was recruited to help Corey. Noon. It's not my fault, huh? So I help also Marcos. Then after that, Corey. Then Fidel Ramos. See, up to ano? Now, even si Gulingit. I mean, si Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. And hindi ako makapasok. Yeah? Samantalang pag governor siya, congressman, see, actually, I like executive, huh? Governor, mayor, either municipal or city, siyang kausap ko eh. Diba? So, action ka agad yun. Diba? Saka kuma-attend nung seminar ko. No, so, Joseph de la Cruz, when I was giving the seminar on survey, ando siya, throw up, right? Anyway, so one of the questions in, gusto mag-introduce ni Governor Josie ng health insurance para sa masa, Medicare para sa masa, okay? Well, the issue was, of course, pricing, one of the issues, okay? So, I did the research for her, what I call non-monetary pricing. See, ano yung non-monetary pricing? It was defined by Adam Smith way, way back, the father of modern economics. Ano sabi ni ano, right? Maalis ko rin. Butchle. Sorry. No. Sabi ni Adam Smith, the real price of anything is the toil and trouble that you go through when you really want to get that item. Not monetary price. Okay? So I did my research on that. Okay? So one of the research that I've done was specific on that. Pero ano lang siya, ha? Qualitative, okay? So what I call waiting time cost and embarrassment cost. Right? So this is part of the pretest of my survey under Fidel Ramos, who gave me a project called the Social Marketing Survey of Downscale Pregnant Women in 41 Social Reform Agenda for Philippines. Huh? Oh, kompletong budget ito. Okay? No, so I'm grateful to Fidel Ramos for that. So anyway, this portion of the pretest, just think that you saw this. No, I'm giving this out, and right? Huh? Andy, okay. So you will have a copy of this, huh? So maybe you can just read this, okay? ito talaga nakakaawa, ha? The toil and trouble that they will go through, okay? So, anyway, read that thing. What about the monetary cost? Oh, see, so I'm an economist, see? So, I applied my economic model for price determination, which is the price elasticity of demand. But I changed it, instead of an econometric model, I changed it, see, into data that is not actual, see, but survey generated, huh? And I was successful, see? Well, a little prayer helps, okay? So, alright. So, yun yung beneficiary responsive pricing. So, I was able to convert it into survey-based data, okay? And the logic was very simple, di ba? If you look at the prescription from the price elasticity of demand, it says the following. You can go on increasing price as long as the total revenue increases with each price increase. Okay? Stop when the last price increase gets you zero revenue increase. And the next price increase results in a decline of total revenue. Pataas siya ng pataas, tapos pag increase ng increase yung price, pababa siya. You have hit, see, the revenue maximizing price. Pastor, with one question? Grabe yun, di ba? So, see, I was jumping up and down, right point. Well, that's the thrill, see, of research for me. Okay? Sabi na nung misis ko, how can a mountain full of data, see, get you so excited? Sabi ko, ikaw ba, di ba, you get also excited about something? Ano? When you ask me to buy a Gucci watch, ang tingin ko dito sa bundle of data nito, mounted for data, is like a Gucci watch. Okay? It is seen by everyone, see, but thinking that a thought that nobody had. Yun ang insight. Di ba? So that's the one that's exciting for me. See? It's much better than, you know what? Okay, anyway. So ito yung resource niya, okay? So, the revenue maximizing price was 95 premium per month for the poor. Was extreme poor ito. Otherwise, there's 68% of the poor in Bulacan ready to dish out 95 pesos a month. See, to be a member of this scheme. Okay? So, saan mo kay Governor Josie? Josie, tingnan mo ito. Paso tayo dito. See, 95 pesos a month lang. Okay? Pero sabi niya, pero, how many will we get? Sabi niya, 68%. So, 32% will not be for. Tignan mo, iba talaga mag-isip ang politician, ha? No. Look, that's why I myself believe that we need politicians. Bakit? Iba sila mag-isip, eh. This Josie de la Cruz, kasi marami na siyang pareho niya, ha? Okay? Was thinking, 32% will not come in. That's too many. See, so, ano yan? Sorry. I forgot to turn off my... Oh, you are my witness. I am here. Okay? Okay, see? Sabi niya, that's too many. Okay? Sabi ko, pwede mo na sila i-qualify. Sabi niya, that will be a logistical nightmare. 32% see, of the adult, see, of the family, see, of Bulacan. Ang parami noong Dr. Ned. Okay? Sabi ko, paano? Sabi niya, what's the lowest I can go down to? Sabi ko, ayun, see, 50 pesos. Okay? Yung 50 pesos. How many will not qualify? 3%. Oh, yun. I can tolerate that. Sabi ko, you will not get back revenue maximizing price. Pasok, pasok na naman siya, ang ganda, sabi niya. What about net revenue? So, ano yun? See, I'm an accounting major. See, my colleagues, see, but I've never heard of such a thing. So, you find this in, you know, net revenue is gross revenue minus the subsidy. Okay? Ano ang po siya? You know, when we computed the subsidy, so, saan siya ako na? Ayan, no? Net revenues, ang subsidy mo is 3% to not qualify. See, net revenue is 4,700. Ang pangit naman nung. So this is a terrible mistake, huh?
Gabi to eh, Andy eh. Kasi sabi mo, 50 minutes lang. Pero, tingnan mo yan, no? Mas mababa pa yung ano eh, yung red revenue ng ano, di ba? Ng 95. Sabi ko kay Joseph, galing mo naman. Okay? You should teach this. I mean it. Di ba? Kasi iba mag-isip ang politician. Okay? Also, okay? Sabi ko sa kanya, alam mo, over the years, I have developed a liking for politicians. Okay? Not the bad politicians, but politicians who are concerned, okay, about the constituency. Okay? Bakit? Kasi yung politician, marunong, they can greet somebody they hate. As if they like them, ba? Okay? Ano sasabi sa akin dito? Ako, itong hype na to. May hapi yan, ba? Pero, oh, kamusta? Can you do that? No. So I can't qualify as a politician. Diba? We need those who will be, ha? Huh? Okay. So anyway, oh, so yun ang ginawa niya. Tapos meron din akong beneficial pricing sa friendly care clinic. See? So I have them there. So maganda. Basahin niyo lang ito, ha? Okay. Oh, learning from my research naman sa mga companies. Well, I just have two, ha? Dalawa lang, ha? Because these were the two most challenging to me. Okay? So ito yun, no? What I have started as a consumer coping behavior survey, and the other one is where I applied my acquaintance with archaeology and the archaeological research method. Okay? This is a bit exciting. That is exciting for me. Okay? So ito yung ano. This I am now I now have a 2013 version and wave of the consumer coping behavior study and survey, which I started way back in 1984 85 86. In 1984, as you remember, that was the year after Aquino's assassination, right? And so on, and it continues here up to 2012, and now there's one. Okay, so ano yung sabi niyan? No, ang sabi niyan was done that really with the question. In 1984, the Philippine Marketing Association asked me, he said, "Dr. Ned, meron ka bang research on how exactly the poor are able to make both ends meet and how they are able to cope?" So, no, wala. Pero kung bibigyan mo ako ng budget, di ba? Why not? Di ba? No, they did, huh? They did. Okay? So it started then. Every year that we have difficulties, oh, there are sponsors who ask me, okay? No, I am not signing. The sponsor came, okay? Which was good because, see, I asked them, I am only going to do this survey if I will own the data. But why do I want to own the data? I will make it available in SWS for students to use in their thesis, in their PhD dissertation. See? Yun ang concern ko. Okay? Well, that's the primary motivation for doing things. Huh? Aside, of course, from being able to help businesses as well as NGOs and government see about the results of this data. Tingnan ang data ko, ha? Isang question lang, oh, kasi bakit? 159 product categories and service categories. If you have 159 and you use one UAI question, hindi ka matatapos dyan, di ba? So I had to innovate, okay? I like that, okay? Research innovation, okay? So my innovation was to say, oh, I will get all the data that I need with just one question. That was this question. Here's the question. Okay? Mrs. Okay? Bakit si Mrs.? Kasi this is a family budgeting behavior survey. Family budgeting. So therefore, it must be from the manager of the family, who is the housewife, okay? Now, of course, because of the OFW phenomenon, see, many of the houses that we have now, see, are managed, and their budget is managed by the husband. Okay? Okay lang. Here's the question, no? Ito ang nakalaang apat na buwan, eh? Paano, ano ang ginawa ninyo dito sa inyong budget? See? Sa bawat isa, dito sa 159 product categories, have you tick off, boss? Tick off. So each of the category can be answered in 3 to 5 seconds. So, tapos kami.
sa survey, three in one, in 25 minutes. Okay? And what do I have? I have all of this data. Okay? I can now ask, what's the largest set of business growing, para sa mga businesses, ha? Business growing opportunities. Is it in the product service categories? Okay, and what coping market segment? Yung coping market segments ko are maintained into this. Maintenance segments, those who stayed and maintained the product category in their budget. The lapser segment, those who gave up. See? Kasi na, masyado na mahal. Tapos, and then the non-users. Ano yung non-user? I mean, plus, can you imagine in 2008, see, fast food, Jollibee, McDonald's, Wendy's, and so on, right? In Metro Manila, 27% of all housewife population, see, in Metro Manila, had never entered a fast food. 27%. Can you imagine what kind of a business you could get if you get 27%? Immediately, your share of market will go up 27%. How you feel, di ba? Okay? Anyway, those are the kind of things I was able to answer with this. Huh? So, yan yung okay. So, the wow segmenting prescription. Right? So, let me introduce my son, my favorite son, my only son. That's it. His name is Ned Roberto. He's in Facebook now all the time. And he's in Channel 7, Channel 5, Channel 2. Okay, why? Because he decided to get married to Miriam Kiambao. Sabi ko, pambihira ka na. Ano na ko sa lasal eh, bakit hindi si Megan Young? Okay. So, ito yung mga tiyanong ko. Ba? So, I have the, oh, look at this, oh, the definitely indispensable categories. Ano yun? See, a product category I can do without. You know language of consumer? I can do without. Definitely can do without. I can live without that. Okay? Yun naman, staple, yun naman, see, category, I cannot live without. Sino number one do? Detergent. Sino number two? Toothpaste. What about rice? Oh, pero way down below. Staple din siya, pero way down below. Okay? You know, they can live without. Many can live without, okay? Siyempre, ang question ng sponsor doon, okay? How can that be, Dr. Ned? Oh, yun. Yun ang pasok mo ng ano, qualitative research. So I drew, see, the respondent for the FGD from those who answered that way. Oh, sa inyo pala, you cannot live without, see, detergent. Yun ang number one para sa inyo. Oh, see, ano ang nangyari? Ano yung yun? Bakit siya, kayo, parang you cannot live without that. Kasi sabi niya, eh mas, ang hirap-hirap na nga ng panahon. Tapos wala pa akong detergent. Eh di, ang baho-baho ko, mahirap na nga ang panahon, tapos mabaho pa ako. Di ba? Which is psychology, boss. It's not Aristotelian, Socratic logic, but it is, see, consumer psychology. Right? Okay, so, those kind of insights, huh? So, ayan yung mga ano, ganyan. Right. Now, let me introduce to you the cheapest and most cost-effective. Huh? Bakit? Kasi wala siyang necessary budget for a survey. Huh? So, when did this happen? When this happened, when a client of mine says to me, eh, gusto kong malaman pa paano naging successful si Corn Tuna. Kasi yan naman si D.O. Hindi kagaya ang D.O. yun, ha? Diba? Corazon D.O. Winner of the Ernst and Young, the Entrepreneur of the Year. She started in the grants. Diba? Tapos ko din. Married to a professor of engineering in UP, who is my friend. Okay? Anyway, paano mo matutuhan niya ang ginawa na, ano? Was she able to innovate that way? So, siyempre, sabi ko, oh, kailangan mo itong benchmarking. Tanungin natin siya. Okay? So, can you ask Corazon Dion? Kanta-kanta niya. Natanda na siya, pero kanta pa rin. Okay? So, I called up and I had an appointment. See? Sabi niya, nako, I'm sorry. Hindi ho pwede. Kasi ang dami hong gustong gumaya nito. So, being a marketing man, eh, what is your biggest quality as a marketing professor? Persist. Do not give up. So, eh, baka ako, meron lang siyang period noon, di ba? Postpone. So, I call again, then I call again, ayaw talaga. Ha? So, I persisted. How? Sino kaya asawa nito? Poof! Kilala ko. So, tawala ko yung asawa. Di ba? So, so. Jin, pwede ba nung ito? Sabi niya, sorry Ned, ha? Kaibigan kita, pero you, I am like you. I'm like you. You all are also a very understanding husband. So, hindi natin pwede. So, pa, ano gagawin ko na? I resorted to a research method that I learned from my archaeology professor in Northwestern. Okay? How was that? Ito nga, it's called deconstruction method. I still have to figure out why they call it deconstruction, because actually when you resort to it, it is constructing. Huh? Constructing for what? Constructing, see, the innovation process, okay, out of so-called artifacts. Di ba ganun archaeologist? No, Harrison Ford, Indiana Jones. Okay? You collect artifacts, di ba? Okay, you, oh, I am amazed at archaeologists, di ba? Naka-discover lang ng broken tooth, tapos a fragment of a bone, and then they construct the dinosaur and the type of dinosaur. Okay? So I said, what kaya yun? Diba? So I studied archaeology. Kasi I was enjoying myself in my PhD in Northwestern so much. So I cross-enrolled everyone that I can. Okay? Anyway, they collect artifacts. So in this case, what are the artifacts? The speeches of the president, the website, the advertisement, the packaging, the content of the packaging. Well, until that, you know. See? And then you put it together and you analyze and you will come out how they came out. Huh? So, yun yung ginawa ko. Okay? O, oh, yun yung discovery ko. Okay? So, yung sa point 2 na, dyan o, dyan. See? I think, see, out of the artifacts that I got, I think she thought about a segment, a market segment, huh? Which is good. Because in marketing, you can never enter the entire market. That's why you have to remember, you have to identify a segment. Okay? See? Alright. This segment, see, seems to me, out of the advertisement, blah, 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 seems to be addressed mainly, not only of course, huh, but mainly to fish, segments of fish eaters who used to be meat eaters and who are missing something, see, about the fish. What is it that they're missing? I have a question. But what is it that you miss most in eating meat? Okay? So yun, kinukul ko rin doon sa artifact, di ba? Kasi ito yung sinasabi doon sa advertisement, for example, di ba? Okay? And they answered that way. Anyway, in-eliminate ko my answer. They said, sana yung fish na kinakain ko ngayon, okay, tastes like corned beef. Kaya corn tuna. Ayun, di ba? Ang galing. Yeah? See, I think. Okay? But, I discovered that. So, my client, I said, well, ganito yung ginawa niya dyan, no? Sinod nila. Kaya then they presented an imitation of corn tuna. Okay? So, how can you be quick but clean and be cost effective? I say, apply the science of management to designing and doing survey research. Okay? So, sometimes you have to be an entrepreneur, not a manager. Sabi, you're wrong. Okay? There is no distinction between a good entrepreneur and a good manager, okay? An entrepreneur who does not know how to manage will fail eventually. And they will manage. A manager who is not an entrepreneur and devotes himself to continuous innovation, see, will set the stuff, okay? So you have to be both, okay? So, I am against the idea, see, of distinguishing entrepreneur and manager, okay? They have to be both, okay? Alright, so apply the science of management. Ano yung science of management to research? Ito lang, oh. See, so I divide the survey research process into basically three sets,
of stages. Research design stage, see survey data collection, survey data tabulation, and then survey the analysis and reporting. The first and the last, I call that bookend stages. See, the one in the middle is called the middle stages. Okay? Where are you? Well, is the biggest number of people in? It's in the middle. Di ba? Ang dami mong data collector, interviewers, and so on. Right? But look, today, the survey research industry has divisionalized and functionally divided themselves. Okay? Meron mga specialists in data collection and tabulation. Tapos, meron naman specialist doon sa bookend. When after my operation and my retirement from AIM, my clients insisted that I should completely leave the survey research industry. Okay? And they said, wala na namin kitang consultant. Pag usahang consultant, doon, yung tinatawag kong bookend. So that's what I do na. Okay? And I found out, see, parang very lucrative. Why? Because I set up for the companies, see, a do-it-yourself survey research group. See? Which can cut down, see, their survey research budget, see, as much as 50, 55, 60%. 40% lang ang gagastos nila ngayon, no? With the same set of research, okay, that they used to have. Huh? But anyway, oh. So do-it-yourself organize. Oh. How do you organize your people? Then do-it-yourself organize. For the bookend stages, okay, have a lean team of three. So 2 years ago, I just finished setting up a do-it-yourself research group and team for 4 companies, owned by one person. Huh? Si Manolo Agustinez, okay? There's Rancar, KFC, Tokyo Tokyo, at saka Mr. Donut. Okay? Pero, meron silang ano, do-it-yourself research team of how many? Total of 12. 3 people. Okay? How much were they able to save in the process? See, on our very first year, 8 million. 8 million. They were able to save. How did you estimate what they were able to save? I don't know. Formerly, you used to get, see, all of your research by a full service survey research agency, right? So, kinuha ko yun. Ito yung bill dyan. Tapos ako, oh, ngayon, we are doing the same research. How much it cost you? Okay? See, the full service minus what it costs us, it costs savings. Okay? Kaya hindi ako sumingil. Okay? Sabi ko, okay? Look. Okay? I bill you on performance. Okay? I bill you on savings. What is that calculating your savings? Oh, ganito. Okay? And you can do due diligence if you want. They did. Okay? Oh, magkano yung singing mo? Sabi mo, 15% of the savings. Sabi ko, ito nga. Sabi ko, ano eh? Anong gusto mo? Sabi niya, 10% na lang. So, look, this is the biggest insult that I ever got from any client. Ba't naman? Hindi ba 10% yung waiter? Are you treating me as a waiter? Ay, yung consultant. Di ba? Nakakaya naman yun. Di ba? See, parang kumita lang ako sa'yo, okay? Hindi na bali, ha? Kalimutan natin ang pagkakaibigan natin. Isusumpa na kita. Sumpa mo na rin ako. Ganyan pala ang trato mo lang sa akin. Diba? Samantala, I know. See, when you ask Manny Pacquiao, see, to appear in your advertisement of your Motolite battery, see, how much does he charge? Oh, 1 million pesos by just putting in his head Motolite battery. Okay? And I'm setting up for you, see, something that will last for you to the end of your company. Okay? Kung ganyan lang ang pagtingin mo sa akin, sayang. Sayang ang pagsasama natin. Kalimunan natin lang. Kasi lang tayo ng kandila. Okay? Siyempre, with that drama touches their heart. And they said, hindi naman ganun. Di ba alay? Kaya nga, I know the truth. Kaya lang ang pagtingin mo sa akin. Kaya pala kababa ang pagtingin mo sa akin. Wait there. Sabi niya, sige, kaya mo lang. Sige, di ba? All I'm saying is, boss, if you get into research quick and clean and cost-effective, there's money in it. I assure you. Okay? And there's big money in it. Okay?
So yun ang guarantee ko to sa aking six mentees. See, if they convert themselves into good researchers, quick, clean, and cost-effective researchers, they will be superstar research professors of the world. Oh, you're beyond the world. Okay. And I'm not exaggerating. Okay. This is a promise that you can have for yourself. Huh? See, those other schools that are here. Okay. All right. So I work. How do you work organized? So I always like a team. Huh? But my team concept is not just an ordinary team. It is what I call a winning playing team. Like what? See? Like this surgical team that operated on me when I had the 50-50 chance of staying because I had a quintuple bypass. Okay? So, tinigot mo niya, ang screen ko, ba? So, yung surgeon was a world-renowned, si cardiac surgeon, si George Garcia. Tapos, sino member ng team niya? Anesthesiologist, tinigot background niya, ba? Tapos, then I observed when they were operating. Okay? Isang glass, ano? Okay? Kaling, without being told, oh, there's no coach, di ba? See, each one is automatic. Bang, pasok yung anesthesiologist, pasok yung ano, di ba? Pasok yung nurse, sorry. Okay. Okay. And of course, see, the other winning playing team is De La Salle basketball team. Oh no, yung coach is outside, di ba? And this is a, parang ano, lahat ng players alam, di ba? Yung center alam ang kikilos, yung forward, ganun ang team. So, if you want to have a clean, okay, quick but clean and cost-effective research setup, you try to form such a team, okay? And it's the hardest thing to do, okay? Tapos, so, what about cost? Oh, yun nga, oh. See, so, alin ang pinakamalaking cost? Eh, yun sa mid stages, di ba? It is 55%. 45% yung sa book ends. Huh? And if you do this for a growing period of time, it can be lower. Huh? Lower what? Yung book ends. Okay? From 45, you can bring it down to 30. Okay? My experience is, I'm able to bring it down to 30. And you have a lot of savings. When you have a lot of savings, then your commission in absolute amount goes up. Huh? See, tapos, then you resort to ito yung mga research agents, survey research agents. There is what I call full service research agency, which is AC Nielsen, Taylor Nations of Press, SWF, PSRC, and so on. And then you have your field and tab agencies. Huh? These are the ones are my favorite. Okay, because they are accredited by the Market and Opinion Research Society of the Philippines. Huh? Kasi marami nang pumapasok dyan na fly by night. Huh? Okay. So therefore, what survey, what agency? Pero sana, oh, this is how I do it with my clients. Okay? So I partition the survey research project into first, highly confidential and immediately needed, or sa loob yun. Okay? Large scale and monitoring, sa labas yun. Hindi nyo kaya yun. Okay? So, and then the highly confidential, oh, sa atin ninyo. Okay? And then for the immediately needed projects, do it yourself. Okay? For the large scale monitoring, sa labas yun. Okay? And kung nag-experimento pa naman, you take advantage of the what is called the omnibus survey. Huh? See, AC Nielsen is famous for its omnibus survey, okay? Which is cheap, huh? Because 1,500, 1,200 total sample, they bill you by the your question, 24,000 per question. See? If you do the national survey of 1,500, it will cost you mga 2 million to 3 million now. Pero, you have 10 questions, so times 27,000 pesos, times 10, di ba? 27,000. See, for a national survey, okay? But tapos din nga, then, see, eventually, I set up yung mga kumpanya that I have. So, sabi ko, oh, you will go from research project to research program, to research system, okay? Where even our salespeople have access to the research, okay? And can guide them in their selling, okay? Tapos what about real research management? So very quickly na, ha? Kasi I'm concerned about the way that you approach your research management and research culture in your school. So let me talk about the case of the of De La Salle, where I'm now conducting my research mentoring. Okay? So at the beginning, ganito ang tingin ko, ha? When I entered, see, open strategy, ha? What's my open strategy? Encourage every faculty members to publish in pre-selected high impact journals, okay? Which is in the BLSU Faculty Development Program, okay? Or accept what I'm offering, okay? Which is selective strategy, ha? Pre-select those to constitute the eventual 10 to 20% research professors. Okay? Di ba elitist yan? No. Okay? Bear me out, okay? Sino nagsabi nito? Eh, di sa iyo. Tos, napakagwapo talaga. Bakit na? Ang hindi naman pare, di ba? Pwede pa ito, ha? Oh, De La Salle vision. No. Ang De La Salle vision, okay, is to be a leading learner center research university. Okay? So, bakit ako kinuha ni Brother Ricky? Kasi sabi niya, we are a true research university as far as all, most colleges are concerned. Eh? So, medicine, engineering, IT, blah, and so on. Pero, we are not a research university as far as the College of Business is concerned. Okay? Konti-konti kami ito. Eh? We're thin. So, I understand you did research mentoring at AIM and then also with other schools. See, ngayon, si Vince Pabella ng Sarasar University, was a friend of mine. Okay? In fact, he was a student of mine. He's asking me if I could set up a similar thing that we have here. Okay? Anyway, okay? So, kasi gusto niya rin maging research university. No? To qualify for accreditation, right? So I say, so sabi ko kay Brother Lugo, Brother, reframe mo, ah, reframe again your strategy choice, huh? So that you don't say or, you say both this and that. Huh? That is open strategy as well as a selective strategy. Kasi nga, okay. Nangangapako pa eh, hindi ko pa sigurado kung ano eh, ba? Alright, so, see, very few things came out of the open strategy, okay? But that's not a reason for you to give it up, okay? Okay? Because meron naman kumagat dun eh, ba? So therefore, oh, so subukan mo rin ito sa atin, ha? So, what is the correct pre-selection? Okay? How do you pre-select, okay? Eh, yun ang sabi ko, pareho, di ba? So, ito yung aking hero for that. Sabi niya, in any choice situation, avoid framing your choice decision as either or. Bakit? Kasi that's a lose-lose choice. That's a prisoner's dilemma. Okay? And you only apply it, see, when there is an emergency. You are not in an emergency situation here in your school and university. Okay? So, see? So therefore, you frame it as both this and that. Okay? Either or is a prisoner's dilemma choice. Both and is a win-win choice. Okay? So why not, therefore, ito yung branding ko sa aking research mentoring sa, dito sa, even in AIM, I used to call it that. Huh? Not publish or perish, but publish and flourish. Kasi nga, ang daming pera dito boss. Okay? Alright. So it's about the kind of research university we want to become. See, like see an Ivy League. See, sino ba nang umpisa niya? Wharton in the Harvard. Okay. So tingnan mo ang Wharton ngayon, no? This is what they can say. See, after devoting all their investing heavily on research professor. Okay. This is in their brochure. Okay. But just look at the beginning. Okay. Wharton's 225 world-leading faculty members create a living network of ideas. Challenging you, student, okay, to bring your own ideas to them. Our professors are thought leaders in their respective field. Half have active consulting practices in businesses. Half have practices. So the other half is what? The other half is in research. that's 50%. Hindi yung 10 to 20% that is demanded see by the accreditation, di ba? So sa akin, ito yung talagang ultimate. Okay? And nobody had reached that. No school of business or college of business in the world has reached that. Okay? Alright. So until, see, therefore, we can say something about our business school faculty and research near to what Wharton says, we have yet to succeed in the effective, efficient management of our research in our business school. Okay? So in closing, let's pray. Okay? For persistence. Who is my hero in persistence? Next president, the so-called handsomest president of the United States, Calvin Coolidge. Oh, yan, sabi niya, oh. Diba? Semo.
Nothing in this world can take the place of persistence. Talent will not. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful people of talent. Genius will not. Unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence and determination alone have solved and always will solve the problems of the human race.
Yes, indeed. So will you join me in a prayer? All together, please. Let us lose courage in considering our own perfection, but instantly set about remedying them. Every day, begin the task anew. Diyo ba? Persistence yun, diba? You said that. The saint of marketing. Sales. Saint Francis the Sales. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Ned. The floor is now open for our question and answer. So kindly approach the microphones near you, and before you ask your question, just introduce yourself and your organization or university where you belong.
We just have time for maybe 2-3 questions, but you'll have an opportunity to interact with Dr. Ned later.
Okay, let me put it this way, okay? Yeah, I noticed that some people were writing notes, okay? So, if you look at your notes, there may be exclamation point. Your exclamation point means, see, you were surprised, okay? See, and you were asking yourself, how does that apply to me? So, yung application question, yun, di ba? Meron naman dyan, yung note yan, meron siya, question mark. Ano yung question mark? Hindi malinaw yung sinasabi itong matandang ito. So, yun ang clarification question. So, I welcome clarification as well as application question. Sige na. Okay, yes. Si, introduce your name and your affiliation.
So, my name is Patch.
Plural ng Pat.
I'm part of the Center for Business Research and Development. So I'm under Dr. Aberandas and my colleagues. So actually, we're very involved in for-profit social entrepreneurship.
Oh, no.
So, and I was also part of MarkProp. So we also discussed about how marketing is related to being really originating from a consumer perspective.
Oh.
But my question is, when it comes to for-profit social enterprises, it seems that they need to originate from the consumers, pero kailangan, they need as well to tie it with the community. So, if we're out of a marketing perspective, how do we consider really beginning from both the consumer and the community perspective?
Oh! Pwede nito, ha? Sa muna ko ito. Pagkatapos mo, sato na lang siya. Okay, see, so, Pats, that's an important issue and a question, ha? Okay, so how do you see to it that you pay respect to the beneficiary or consumer as well as the interests and concerns of the community? Okay, alright. So that has to do with your needs assessment. Okay, So, I wish we had more time, because to me, that's the most important portion of your social entrepreneur research. See? To make an assessment of the needs of the individual, consumer beneficiary, as well as the needs, see, of the entire community, okay? Which are not necessarily symmetrical. Asymmetrical na siya, di ba? Sometimes what is the need of the individual, it does not reflect the need of the community and the community's need. Often also is not necessarily the need of the individual, okay? So meron akong tatlong needs assessment method to apply there, okay? So I have, see, a needs assessment method for the specific problem. Specific problem can be individual, see, or a group, or a community, okay? So pwede yun. Then, I have needs assessment method for the family, okay? So, pwede rin yun, okay? Then, I have a needs assessment method for the entire community. Entire community being defined, see, by the national community, even global or international, down to the barangay, okay? So, ito yung tinuturo ko ngayon doon sa Hap Pinoy. Kasi mayroon sila mga community stories. Okay? So, ang nakikita lang doon sa community stories nila, okay? The needs of the entire community, okay? Is only partially satisfied by what they're doing in the community stories. Okay? Tapos, and the interest and concern of some individuals, lalo na yung very extreme poor. Kasi out of the 15% extreme poor, meron tayong mga 3 to 4% who are hungry every day. Can you imagine that? Hungry every day. Diba? So, you know, see? Ah, sabi mo, eh, 3 to 4% lang pala. Ano ka ba? Diba sabi nga ni Jesus Christ, if you save one soul, anyway, see, so, those are the issues that we have. And since sabi ko, you can get a clue to the solution if you apply the appropriate needs assessment method. Okay? That it might help you, okay? Get into an insight that you do not have as yet. Kasi sa akin, it's the insight thing that is concerned there. Okay? Now, many times naman, miski itong sila Pamakino, sila Rubik, Mark Ruiz, tapos sabi na, eh, Doc Ned, di ba analysis paralysis yan? Di ba? Do you see me as paralyzed already? What do you mean to say? No. Pag meron kang occasion when you indeed see an analysis paralysis, I say it's not because of the analysis. It's because of the wrong analysis. Mali yung pagka-analyze. Diba? So, if you partition, for example, analysis into stages of decision-making, right? That is a definition of the problem, okay? And generating options, evaluating the options, okay? And so on and so forth. Ito pa lamang sa umpisa eh, yung analysis paralysis na yun, nandoon na yun. Mali yung definition of the problem, okay? And many times, those who say, parang nag-analyze na ako ulit eh. So, let me see how you analyze. Mas makita ko, inulit lamang yung analysis na ginawa. Eh, alam mo itong mali eh. Tapos pa ulitin, di ba? Antik sa mga ulo mo. Yeah. Biro lang yun. Hindi naman ako. Those are some of the considerations that you must think of. Huh? So therefore, let me invite you to be one of my mentees. The second time around. Are you a professor? Huh? Ano? Ah, you just graduated, huh? Okay, so, huh? Ako, hindi ko abutin ito. Okay, thank you. Sige. Ano pa? Yes, please.
I'm Noreen Ferrada. I'm a math diploma student of this university and also into thesis writing. That's why I'm here.
Ah, okay.
But my question would be, in finding you, although there's an email there, I'm working with the Supreme Court. And we're not used to survey research. We're only dependent on SWS and the JARIO. Okay, it's more of how can we find and bring into the into our institution governance-related research that you're doing?
Okay. So let me tell you the background to the governance, local governance research that I did for mayors, governors, especially the one that I did for Governor Jose de la Cruz. Eh? Okay. Nung una, siyempre, Governor Jose was also the same as all other members of the League of Governors. Okay? So, yung League of Governors, were of the same mind, eh? So, although they would invite me every so often to give a kind of silang League of Governors meeting, so they need a speaker. Okay? And since many of them are my students in social marketing, sa IIM, eh, so we have, oh, si Professor Ned na lang. Look at the word, eh? Professor Ned na lang. Na lang eh. So I would ask, eh, ba't ako na lang? Kasi, sir, kasi kayo, bastos kayo eh. At saka, you're full of green jokes. Yung pala yun ang hinahanap ng League of Governors. Okay? Anyway, so out of that, okay, I would actually invite myself. So yung, saan ba yung next meeting nyo? Uy, mayroon akong bagong topic yan. Okay? Oh. What does that mean? Yung finlas ko na huli, persistence. Okay? You persist. But when you persist, do not do the same thing. Okay? Okay na ha, may bagong topic. Yeah? Okay? So, out of that, see? Tignan mo, nilapitan ako, unang-unang lumapit sa akin si Josie, tapos yung mayor ng Cagayan de Oro, tapos yung sa Palawan. Okay? Lumapit sa akin, sabi ko, tersante ko dun sa ano? Yung sa sabi ko saan? You know, kasi mayroon akong Medicare para sa masa. And, ang issue ko ngayon, sabi ng ating mga members of Santo Niño, palalawigan, dapat yan, libre. Kasi government to eh. See, so, yung health insurance niya, dapat libre yan. O sabi ko, ano nangyari? Sabi ko naman niya doon sa Santo Niño, palalawigan, eh, kung libre ito, hindi matutuloy ito. Kasi even my era will not be sufficient to fund it. Right? So, we have to present it as for sale, okay? For purchase by even the extreme poor. So sabi daw sa kanya nung, siyempre, yung vice governor, di ba? Kasi yun na nag-ambisyon na maging governor. Sabi sa kanya, nako, walang bibili niyan. Okay? So at which point, hindi siya nakakibo, kung tinayin niya sabi mo, magbalik ka doon sa another meeting and then say na, no, there is a way of finding out kung bibili o hindi. It's a research issue pala. Okay? Oh, I'm giving you Professor Ned Roberto from AAM to do the research for free. Ang totoo yun, for free, di naman yun. Bakit? Kasi I'm looking for materials for a new book. Okay? No, I'm not all. Okay, so I'm always to run. So ang deal ko sa kanya, I'll do that for free, provided I own the data, so that I can publish it. No, I did. I wrote a book for her. Okay? It was a bestseller, boss. Sold out the first 1,000 copies was sold out immediately. Bakit? Hindi nila ni Josie. Parang pumigay ito sa mga bisita sa governor's palace. Okay? Anyway, kidding aside. Okay? So, you own. Okay? So, you be opportunistic. But you be opportunistic by maximizing your exposure, see, to the opportunity that you will be able to persuade. Okay? Ayun ha? Persist, be opportunistic, see, be lulukat, and be creative. Okay? Kasi, okay? Don't give up. Okay? Kasi ganito ang ano yan, sa Pilipinas, di ba? Persistence always work, eh, di ba? Kasi ganito ha? Oh, balik ako ng balik. Okay? Sabihin sa akin ng kliyente, okay? Ano yung business, eh? Ano ka pa? Bill, ano ko kulit mo man? No! Kumisan, tala ang sando niya. No! Kapal! No, che-check ko pa yan. I will let 1 week, 2 weeks pass. O, tabi, tawag ka naman. Iba naman ang pasok ko. Pero, namit ko siya, no? Pinakamusta niya yung, kasi nabalita ko sa kanya. Meron akong napatira. So, balik. So, you know what the Filipino will do? Sabi niya, anak, kapwa na. Napakulit mo. Sige na nga. They say yes eh. Eventually. So, take advantage of that. That's what I call being opportunistic. Huh? So, develop the skill of being opportunistic in a positive way. Hindi yung negative way, ha? Huh? Hindi yung persistence ni Napoles. Trouble ka yan. Okay? Ano pa? Yes, please.
We'll close now. And then if you have the questions, more questions for Dr. Ned, we'll just continue it after the program. Before we proceed to our closing remarks, we'll just have a few announcements. So if you want to buy a copy of Dr. Ned Roberto's book, it will be available for purchase after after the program. We'll just set up the books here. And then there will be a book signing after this public lecture. Second, for our guests from outside and the faculties who attended, your certificate is ready. So you'll just get it after this event. And then lastly, we have merienda at the Ichenko Lobby, first floor. So we'll just usher you. So let us call the Vice Dean for Research and Graduate Studies of RBRCOB, Dr. Divina Edrelli, to deliver our closing remarks.
This will be a quick and clean closing. So on behalf of the administrators, we would like to thank Dr. Ned. I think this afternoon for everyone, this is really a quick and clean learning about how we will do quick but clean research survey. I think what is interesting for all of us is to hear it from a guru and for one a Filipino, and how we will be able to apply it in changing the world, our world in the Philippines, our world in our school, our world in our community, so that there will be more people who will be able to access the wealth of the nation, the wealth that was given by God. We should be persistent in doing it. So at least we remember four things for faculty: internal validity, external validity, choose the respondent who will be the best person to answer your question. Remember that it should be cost effective, and at the same time ultimately we will find meaning in what we are going to do. So for all the dissertation students who are here, thesis students, good luck to all the faculty. I hope Dr. Ned will have a lot of mentees whom he can inspire to become future Ned Robertos in the future. So thank you very much, sir, and thank you to everyone.
We have something for you, Dr. Ned, a token of our appreciation. An Ateneo dyan, and then a cell dyan.
So again, good afternoon, and today's CBRD public lecture is concluded. So thank you for joining us. So again, if you want to buy and purchase Dr. Ned Roberto's book, it's there.
And again, your certificates are available for those who registered, and Miranda is being served after this. Thank you, and God bless us, everyone.